Hey guys, and welcome to Juno New Origins. My name is Twitchi, and we were playing on this game a couple of weeks ago on stream, and I was like, you know what, this is a great game. Let's go to the menu, let's hit the new game, because I want to do a new thing. I want to go auto tubes. This is my automation playthrough for the YouTubes. Career mode, obviously, default, sounds good. We're going to go in, we're going to say, hi, how's it going? The most important thing that I saw in this game when I was playing with it was an autopilot feature, and I feel like a full autopilot playthrough is one that we are going to go for right now. Congratulations on starting your own aerospace company. It's a tough business, but with my connections, I can help you succeed. Please allow me to introduce myself. I am Algernon Fizzlebottom? I'm going to go with Algernon. The Fizzlebottom is very easy, but I don't know that first name there. I'll be off. I have recently inherited my grandfather's research company, and I own many technological patents. I don't have time to chase the stars myself, so I've decided to offer incentives to new aerospace companies to help them get started. Let's go to the tech tree and see what I can offer you. Well, thank you very much, Alger. Would you like to close this tutorial? No? Can I? Oh, it's up there. Okay, that's fine. I misinterpreted what it wanted me to do. There's probably going to be a bit of that during this season. I'm hoping for weekly releases. If you have a specific day you want this to get released on, let me know. You can earn tech points by completing milestones and visiting landmarks. Using that to unlock perks. Welcome to the tech tree. Click on the Drudman side and see what technologies it contains. Then click unlock. This won't cost any tech tree points, so it's a great bargain. It really is. We get some crew limit, and we get two druids, or a druid, I don't know, many druid. Cost money, cost 1.5 grand, and, oh, they're heavy, 116 kilograms, that's a lot. Anyway, let's unlock this for now. I will take that, thank you much. Fantastic, now unlock common ground. Now, common ground is here. This is tech. We've got a camera, and we've got a label. I'm not sure what the label's displays text for labeling stuff or whatever. You know what, we'll play with it, we'll figure it out. Let's unlock that, we'll take that, thank you very much. Now it's up to you to choose your path, and believe me, anybody that have been around on my channel for any amount of time beforehand will know what my path is going to be. Do you want to start with backyard scientist and build rockets, or start with RC enthusiast and build cars and planes? You only have enough tech points for one, so choose one. But blatantly, the backyard scientist. We get ourselves a command disc gyro, solid fuel types, goblin motors, fins, and contracts that we can take. Is this the only fuel type we've got? Like, do batteries count with that? I know batteries are actually a type of fuel, and I've had trouble whilst experimenting in the past, so maybe we can figure that out on the way. You don't have access to any more technologies for now, so let me show you how to get more tech points. Click the back button at the top left to exit the tech tree. Okay, we did that. We did the thing. Okay, cool. Open the career dialogue. So, of course, as with every space agency out there, I need to make some money. And the way that we make money is selling our services to eccentric billionaires. You have a new customer, Buck Marshall. Hey, Buck, how's it going? Buck Marshall is the mayor of Juno Village, a small settlement in the largest mountain range in Drew. He's been trying to promote the aerospace sector in the region, and finally someone gets to use the infrastructure he constructed. So prepare for challenge. Mucho gusto. Definitely. All right, I'm all about that. Thank you very much. So we got a vertical shot here. When you start to send your fireworks high enough, hitting a house in a village can become a huge problem. But going too far will make finding the scraps annoying. Try to crash no further than 20 kilometers, but no closer than 500 meters. Sorry, from the launch pads. This contract has a tutorial. I don't need a tutorial. We fly by the seat of our pants here. So we need to launch a craft, launch it from the village, be under 1 kilometer above the ground. Oh, man. Get your rocket's acceleration up high, above 10 meters per second square. That's above a G. I'm just going to go with that being a G. Reach 20 kilometers. These two do not agree with each other, but okay. Crash 15 meters away from the thing. Okay, got some stuff that we need. Okay, I think we're going to do it. You cannot accept this contract yet. Please finish your... Oh, wait, here. This is where you'll find your contracts. By completing them, you will... I thought it was going to make me do the mission tutorial. That would have made me sad. By completing them, you will get more money necessary to launch new crafts and maybe at better launch locations. You can see your currently available funds at the top of the screen. Can we? Oh, there, here we go. Current money, 5 grand. 5 grand's okay. That's fine. Click on the milestone tabs. Hello. In order to use my patents, I need you to prove that you deserve it. For this, I have set up these milestones. By reaching them, you will earn tech points, which you can unlock new technology in the tech tree. You can see how many tech points you have at the top of the screen. The zero. It's a big old zero. Well, actually, it's quite a small zero. Zero active crafts, zero active jobs. I can only take on one. Okay, that's cool. What's the next? Okay, so we finish a job. We get a thing. Okay, that's cool. Money spent. How many craft launched? 5 or so. Scrapped returns. Okay, well, I think we can do that. Explosions. We get money for explosions. We're definitely going to be doing very well for those. Okay, thank you very much. Click on the exploration tab. These are all the planets we can go to. There's quite a few. I've literally never... We played around on stream. I've played about with the automation systems. I've not gone anywhere. So, you know, that's good. Oh, these are the different suborbital, orbital, landing, picking a location and planting a flag. I don't know what those last two are, but that's cool. All right, that's cool. Click on the exploration. I have. Here you can find the exploration. I'll click on Drew. Okay, thank you very much. I should learn to read the materials. It would probably help quite a bit. Here are the landmarks you can visit and additional milestones you can do in each celestial body. On each celestial body? I don't know which way you want to word that. You can click them to see more details. Okay, let's go back to the contract. No, let's have a look at some of the things. We've got a drone ship south. Oh, these are landmarks we can go see. Some little points of interest. A number of orbits. Hyperbolic, I presume that's the suborbital flight there. Highest climb, deepest dive. Deepest dive might be interesting. Ground distance traveled, highest speed, water, land. Okay, these are some nice milestones here. Let's go back and get some contracts anyway. Select the vertical slot shot contract and then click start tutorial to accept this contract and begin a designer tutorial. I don't want to do the tutorial. You know, I'm gonna do it. Would you like to close this tutorial? Get out of here. We're gonna accept this contract. We're gonna get going. We have accepted this. Thank you very much. It's basically given us a breakdown of what the career is all about. We come in here, we accept contracts, we get money to accept more contracts. There's a tech tree to open up. Oh, it takes a while to load, it turns out. I think we can handle that. All right, this is our spacecraft at the moment. It is just a disc. Let's go into to the build here. And we are looking... Does it tell us what our contracts are? It doesn't. That's unfortunate. We're going to take a moment to have a look. Quick look around. Okay, the only thing I found is this button here. Vertical shot. Okay, it does tell us what we need to do. Reach 25 kilometers and come back safely. Now, this game, it's a pretty standard rocket builder. We go through, we put some parts down. I thought that was going to be much bigger there. Let's drag this out. We're going to make just a very simple rocket. In fact, I don't feel like we even... Why is this so small? More importantly, why is this so big? Should we just shrink stuff down here? We'll come up with a 2-meter rocket. Actually, this is only a meter big. Why is the engine so small then? All right, we'll pop this on the bottom. Can we make it bigger? Is that a thing we can do? I found the make it smaller slider. This is terrible. Okay, well, let's make a size of rocket that they're expecting us to make. A 0.1 meter radius rocket. This feels tiny, tiny. 10 centimeters. 10 centimeters. Okay, basic little sounding rocket. It's 10 centimeters big. Now, I said we'd play around with the text. Let's play around with the text. I literally have no idea how I changed the text. I normally expect everything to be under this button here, but this is not the one. Let's go for a little explore around label text. Here we go. We'll call this the sounding off. Is there a way of changing the, horizontal, right? No. I want this to kind of swivel around if we can. Oh, I like the gradients though. I was kind of hoping there'd be a way of making it flash or read up and down or something like that. But you know, we'll take that. Okay, now let's get to the important part. Over on the right-hand side, you probably didn't see me click that. We've got this little edit program button. And it gives you this almost scratch-like interface. I can come over on the left-hand side. There's a whole bunch of parts that I can kind of blocks, I believe they're called, to come along and push buttons. So like on start, I could then just straight activate my stage. Set the throttle to one. It's a 0-to-1 scale. I've done that. And we keep the pitch at 90, I believe. And that's probably it. I think that's good. Look, we start, we activate the stage, we make sure our throttle is up, and we're looking I think 90 is directly upward. If our rocket turns immediately sideways, we know what went wrong and I need to come back and change the button. But just a very simple, you know what, I feel like we need something else right in here. I cannot just go like this. Display text. We're going to go 5. And now I should be able to right click this and just drag out some more. That's a pretty useful thing that I've found over time is the right click capability to just copy this out. We will be using that fairly often. I wish there was a way to copy both. I'm getting it wrong. I wish there was a way to copy both this and that. I'm pressing shift and now right click. No, that unfortunately still does not do what I was hoping for. But I have now made a little bit of a countdown here. Blah. Off, which of course is very, very important. The whole mission would not have worked if I had not done that. Let's save to craft. I think we're actually ready to go. We're going from the village pad. Let's just launch. I didn't see how much my rocket was going to cost me. I've only got 5 grand in the bank, so I hope it's not going to cost too much to go. Now they did just say crash. There were no parachutes. 5. Look at the top here. 5. Oh, it's hung up. It's just stopped. Why has it just stopped? Have we run out of power? That could be a thing. Let's hit flight log and see what we've got. Nothing there. It's definitely been longer. Wait, why? wait. What? Why? Undo. Let's go back and check. I don't know why that's not... Maybe it didn't like my misspelling here. Let's just form... Oh, look, it's not connected. That's why. Did you see that connect there? I think I was just about to disconnect everything and be like, okay, let's just go. But actually, wow, I'm going to have to go back and check the footage and have a look. But there was definitely a little bit of a gap there that somehow didn't get pasted together. That's interesting. I don't even know how that happened. I'm glad we found it. That's debugging in process there. I just played with it until it worked. 4, 3, 2, 1, blast off. Oh, we actually did. Oh, man. I was worried there for a second. It looked like we were just going to be holding down. Now, I literally am just flying this straight up and we're going to let it crash. I feel like maybe we've over-engineered this for the task in hand. We only need to go above 100 and above 25 kilometers. We've reached... We're definitely going to reach the 25 kilometers. Did this give us the "you have accelerated fast enough" achievement? Was that a thing? You have completed tier 1 of record altitude by exceeding 10 kilometers. Okay, that's good. I'm all about that. But what I'm more about is knowing what my acceleration is. Is that a thing we can find? That acceleration here. Oh, definitely. We were way over the 1G that it wanted us to. Now, unfortunately, they did not give us any way to... Oh, we can't go any faster than this. They did not give us any way of putting a parachute onto this craft, which is very sad. Very, very sad. I'm actually going to turn... that control ring. Now, I can spin this by hand or whatever, but I don't. We're not going to be doing that. This is entirely down to the robot. So I'm going to turn that off like that, and we'll just let it fly its own flight. So far, so good. We've basically done everything we needed to do right now. Now we just need to see... Oh, that's not the turn button that I wanted. Now we just need to make sure that we can crash in the right area. Now, I have done nothing... to make sure that we are going to land in the right spot. Maybe I should have pointed towards the village or something like that, because we are gaining more and more vertical distance as we're talking. This might be an interesting place where I need to work on the design. I 100% did not even consider this part of the process. Hopefully we just land within 25 kilometers, because this is like... planet spin, right? We went up and down and the planet spun this much underneath us. Bam! Your craft has exploded upon impact. And our program ran out of juice. That's fine. We're going to end the flight. We're going to recover the craft. Lol. And save that flight. But that first mission. Round of applause. We did well. Okay, back to the career button over here. Hey, Buck, how's it going? We have done this one. No, in fact, this is the next one. Flight termination system. Oh, I don't get to hand in the mission and they go, well done. Okay, well, fireworks are one of the best inventions of humankind. Fly high and blow up. Reach 30 kilometers above the ground level, select your command disc and blow up the entire craft before it gets too low. Oh, can I do this in the autopilot? I sure hope so. Okay, I think we can do that. I think this is way with it. As long as we can find the command to blow up, then we can definitely do this. Go back to the build, and we need to do a thing in here. Of course, we'll be using exactly the same craft, sounding off. It did well. It did wonders. It did exactly what we needed it to do. So basically, down here, now what we need to do is wait until... And one of the good things, normally you'd put like a condition in here. So we're going to go directly for that. We want something to be above. No, that was below. Above. There we go. That's the one we want. Can I put that in the bin? Thank you very much. So what I would like is I want to have a vessel. Ooh, somewhere in here there is a bunch of stats. Here we go. We want the altitude above ground level to be above. Oh, I've forgotten how far it wants us. But it was 30 kilometers, right? Something like that. And when that is there, do you reckon there is the explode craft part? I'm gonna look through and see what I can find. Okay, we had to turn to the internet for the first time here, and we actually got a Steam discussion thread that the developer has come in and weighed in on. So, of course, someone has done this before me. That always is. They asked about this very problem. Someone, of course, said it's not possible, and then the dev came in saying it was. And it's this little block here, and it's kind of complicated. You've got to select a certain part, and then in here we've got to explode, and you've got to set it to... I presume one would be fine. But what part is this? That's the question. So we've gone through this, we've counted down, we've waited until we're at our target height, and then we've asked something to explode. But the part zero, what does that mean? So we're going to go into here, and indeed, this little part properties box here, and I think it's the additional settings. Part zero is actually the command disk, so we don't need to do anything there to change that. That's good. That's really good, in fact. One thing that I think I might change just a little bit here. Now, this will work. This will work 100%. It will be fine. But I think I'd like to do something with this weight condition. If we come up to the program flow, I should be able to go, hey, whilst we are, this time I want to be under the altitude under... I'm gonna also put an extra couple of, let's say 100 meters on there, just to make sure we are... meeting all the conditions. So whilst we're under that height, I would like to display our altitude. So let's come up here. I'm going to go put this in the flight log. I will put that there, and I'll literally just... I want to copy this. Pop that in like that. That's it. That's all I want to do. And then we'll be able to track where our mission status is. I think this should work. I found the price. I was looking for the price. I found the price. $181. For this, really, that's quite affordable. That's very affordable. Okay, to the village launch pad. Let's go. Now, this should just count down 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 on its own. 4, 3, 2, 1. And off it goes. Any moment. Takes a while. And here we have altitude. Maybe I could have truncated that. Maybe I could also have put some sort of text on there to say what it actually is. But I feel like it's good just to note what it is that we are tracking here. Okay, we are flying hard, flying fast. We're going to get there pretty quickly, though. The text is visible mostly. What is that over there? Do you see that? There appears to be something to go and look at. I wonder how we do that. And whilst Past Me ponders on that particular problem, I would like to tell you about the people who have made this flight possible. That's right. My patrons. Scrolling up the screen right now, you will see a list of names. These are the names of the girls and guys that have gone along to patreon.com/twitchy and made a monthly monetary donation to the channel so that I can continue making content such as this. And really, it's the least I could do to say thank you very, very much. Okay, we're about to get there. That's good. You've reached an altitude. Now it's time to blow things up. You can select a fuel pack, click on it. I'd rather not do this tutorial. Okay, thank you. How do we now just return to... Bam! We did it. Your Vizzy program has run out of juice. We did the thing. The mission has been successful. Let's save that flight and let's go. Well, I think with that, I would like to say thank you very much for joining me for this adventure, ladies and gentlemen. If you're new to the channel by this series, please do feel free to subscribe. And if you're an old regular, let me know what you think of this one. It really does influence what I do in the future. But I will see you next time when we're going to do another one of these. Bye.